Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you ARP protocol. ARP means Address Resolution Protocol. And to understand this protocol, let me tell you how many things that I am going to cover in this video. See, first I will explain you how many basics are there with ARP protocol. After that, I will explain you how working is there with ARP protocol. That I will explain you by one practical example. And at last, I will show you how exactly ARP protocol is working in computer network with the usage of Wireshark software. So in my computer, I'll show you how ARP request is forwarded, how ARP reply comes, right? Everything that I'm going to show you practically even. So let us see first how many basics are there with ARP protocol. So ARP means address resolution protocol, and that we use it to map IP address to physical MAC address. So you should know, first of all, my dear students, in computer network, when you want to communicate, you will be communicating via frames, and those frames will be having MAC address that will be added at data link layer, and those frames will be having IP address that is getting added at network layer. So for frame formation and for frame forwarding, there has to have IP address and MAC address, and that mapping is very essential. And with the usage of address resolution protocol, that mapping is done practically. So in computer network, for frame communication, MAC and IP address mapping, that happens practically via address resolution protocol. See, it is primarily used in IPv4 computer networks. Right now in 2023, majority of computers are using IPv4 communication only, right? And in IPv4, ARP protocol is broadly used, right? In same network communication, destination device MAC address must be there with source device. See, when you communicate in same network, at the time with the usage of MAC address only, directly you can forward the frames, right? There is no need of IP address. But when you want to communicate in other network, at the time there has to have IP address as well as MAC address, right? So here what we are doing is we are mapping IP with MAC address, right? So in ARP, IP addresses are used to identify MAC address. So for example, if you have IP of any device, but if you don't have MAC address, then you cannot forward the frame. So what you need to have is you need to have MAC address of that device, and that MAC address of device, that you can have it by this protocol. I'll show you how it will happen. So let us see how working is there with ARP protocol. So in working of ARP protocol, what I'm going to explain you is here how we map IP address with MAC address. The reason is ARP protocol, that we use it to map IP address with MAC address, right? So let us take one example so that will give you more clarity. See here, let us say device A wants to send data packet to device B within the same network. So here first I'll be considering one example in which I'll be considering two devices in same network. So here we are having device A wants to communicate with device B. So let us say device A wants to send data to device B, right? So device A will check ARP cache. So first of all, you need to understand what is ARP cache. See, ARP cache is a memory, and in that memory, there will be IP and MAC address mapping. So there will be table, and within that table there will be IP and MAC address mapping. So that table is ARP cache, right? So device A will check its ARP cache, that is a table that stores recently resolved IP and MAC address mappings. So ARP cache, that is a table in which IP and MAC address mapping will be there, right? Here device A wants to send data to device B, right? So as if IP and MAC address of device B are available with device A, then it will send the frame to device B. But what if that MAC address is not available with device A? See, right now, as I have told you, ARP cache, that will be having table in which IP and MAC address, that will be there, right? And as if IP address and MAC address, that table is available for device B, then device A can directly forward data, right? Device A can directly forward data over here with the usage of MAC address. But what if device A is not having MAC address of device B? Then it will be using ARP protocol. Let me show you how. See, if MAC address is not found in ARP cache, then device A will send ARP request packet and it will broadcast it to all the devices in local network. See how it will do this. See, device A wants to send data to device B. And here device A is not having MAC address of device B. So what device A wants is, device A wanted to have MAC address of device B, and for that it will be sending ARP request. So that will be a frame, that will be a spatial frame, that will be ARP request frame, right? So this frame will be given to this router one, and router one will broadcast it in this network. Router one will broadcast it in this network. So what will happen, you see? See, this ARP request frame, or you can say this packet, that will be having device A's IP address, as well as it will be having a request for MAC address associated with device B's IP. So in that particular frame, it will be having device A's MAC address, device A's IP address, means sender's IP address, sender's MAC address, as well as it will be having IP address of receiver, right? But it is not having IP, it is not having MAC address of receiver. So it is not having MAC address of B. It is having IP address of B. So it will be having how many information? Sender's IP and MAC address, and it will be having IP address of B, right? Now that is getting broadcasted over here. So when this frame comes to B, B will be having an idea about, okay, this request is there regarding me. The reason is A wants to communicate with B, right? So what B will do now? See, all the devices on the local area network will receive ARP request, but only B will recognize its IP address in the packet and it will respond. So B will send ARP reply. So now you see what B will do is, B will give ARP reply. ARP reply. And now that reply, that will go to router one and it will forward it to A. And in this reply, B will give its MAC address to A. Now A will be having MAC address of B, right? So see, B will send ARP reply packet directly to device A, providing its MAC address, and device A will receive ARP reply packet and it will update its ARP cache. And once it updates its ARP cache, now A will be having IP and MAC address. So now A can forward data to B. See, this is how it is working, right? So here ARP means what? Address resolution protocol, in which, as and when in computer network, if any device wants to send data to another host, then that sender should be having IP and MAC address. And once IP and MAC that is available with sender, it can forward the frame. See, forwarding of frame that will happen via forwarding of frame that has to have MAC address. See, for same LAN communication, it is very compulsory. There must be MAC address. Even though IP is available via IP in same network, communication is not possible. There has to have MAC address, right? In same network, you can communicate it via MAC address, right? See, for other network, it is compulsory. You should be having IP as well as MAC. But in same network, you should be having MAC address. Otherwise, you cannot communicate. So ARP is used to take MAC address with request. So here you will be providing ARP request, and from ARP request, that will be getting broadcasted in network. And once that is getting broadcasted, receiver will get to know, like, okay, somebody is interested to communicate with me. So it will give ARP reply, and that ARP reply contains what? MAC address of that device. And once MAC address is available with that initiator of frame forwarding, then that initiator can send the data to destination, right? So now what I'll do is, I'll show you one practical example on Wireshark software. So to show a practical example, I need to take to you to my computer screen. Now you can observe here, we are having ARP protocol two frames, right? So Here you can observe this is source, which is TP-Link, and this is destination, that is my computer, right? So this is what ARP request. And see, in this ARP request, what it contains, you see. So first let me click on it, and here let me show you how many things are there. You see, this is address resolution protocol, in which, see, size of frame and everything is given. This protocol is there with IPv4, and here you can observe sender's MAC address, sender's IP address is there, but target MAC address, that is not written, but target IP address, that is written. Means target IP address, that is there with sender, but target wants to have MAC address, right? So right now it is 000, so it is now broadcasted in my LAN. Now see, this is what target IP address, right? Now what will happen is, you see, next will be ARP reply. See, this is ARP request. Now next will be ARP reply. Let me click on it. So now you observe, now sender is this, now sender is giving MAC address and IP address of that, and it is targeting to MAC address and IP address of that device. So now this target will be having MAC and IP address of destination, right? So this next frame, immediate frame, that will be ARP reply. First is ARP request, right? So in ARP request, MAC address is blank, you can say it is all zeros, right? And target IP is there. So what it want is, it is asking for MAC address, and once that MAC address is available with sender, it can forward the data, right? So that is how things are there. Now I think, let me come back to my original screen. So probably now you are having fair enough idea, right? And this ARP protocol, that is widely used in computer network, you should know. And this ARP protocol, that we use it to map IP and MAC address, and that will be available in ARP cache, means that will be table in which entries will be there of MAC and IP. If MAC address is not available with sender, then sender will ask for MAC address by ARP request, and by receiving ARP reply, it will update its ARP cache. So this is how it is working. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.